Okay, students, this has been the topics that we have checked during those weeks, okay? We miss one else. This is the finish of quantifier. And now, this is the reason why, because we use thank you very much, okay? I said thank you very much now, but in our hand, we are going to use this example. Thank you very much. O también pueden decir thank you a lot. Gracias. Thank you a lot. Thank you very much. Ya. Okay, chicos. Yo les voy a enviar en este momento a ustedes un Google Form. ¿Sí? Yo les envío un Google Form, o mejor lo hacemos 15 minutos antes de terminar. A las 12 en punto lo vamos a empezar, ¿sí? Yo les voy a enviar un formulario para que ustedes lo completen y vamos a evaluar qué tal nos ha ido esta semana con el aprendizaje, ¿sí? Entonces va a estar compuesto de Present Simple, Present Progressive, possessive adjective, possessive pronouns, quantifiers, todo eso vamos a ver, chicos. ¿Sí? Okay, in this moment we start the next topic that we have for today, which is simple past tense, there was, there were, and used to. Okay? Simple past tense, there was, there were, and used to. Simple past tense, regular and irregular verbs. Verb classification. How can be verbs classified according to the way they form their past tense? Regular and irregular. Regular.
Mister, disculpe, es que no se ve en la pantalla.
Diapositiva de quantifier.
Oh, yeah. Se veía hasta donde decía thank you very much.
Yes.
Yes.
And now we have the simple past. Can you see? Can you watch? Can you see the information?
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much.
Sí, ahí sí se veía.
Simple past tense, regular and irregular verbs. Here we have the verb classification. How can be verbs classified according to the way they form their past tense? Regular and irregulars. Are divided in regular and irregulars. Look at these verbs. Are they regular or irregular? According to what you can remember, dance is regular or irregular?
Regular.
Regular.
Played?
Regular.
Okay. Went?
Irregular.
Irregular. Read?
Regular.
Irregular. Broad.
Irregular.
Irregular. Cut.
Irregular.
Irregular. Came. Irregular, ok.
Irregular.
Like.
Regular.
Next.
Why
is dance a regular verb? Why is sing an irregular verb? Dance is a regular verb and sing is an irregular verb. Why? So let's go to see it. Why is watch a regular verb? Why is it an irregular verb? Here you have watch is regular. It is irregular. Why? We're going to see. Regular verbs, past tense of regular verbs. We just add the letter ed to the end of the verb. Love, loved. Smile, smiled. Regular verbs add ed to the end of the verb. As you can see here, ed, play, played. Take a careful look at the following chart. Simple past tense, positive. I, you, he, she, it, we, you, and they, plus the verb ended in ed. More examples of regular verbs: talk, phone, arrive, play, walk, and ask. Irregular verbs, past tense of irregular verbs: eat, ate. No seguimos un parámetro establecido para recordar la formación de los verbos irregulares. Tenemos que memorizarla a través de la práctica, ¿sí? Irregular verbs don't add ed. They change totally their structure. Cambian totalmente su estructura. Algunos siguen iguales. So we have yesterday, carry. We have the verb hang, hung, up. Her clothes. This is the past tense of the verb hang, el verbo colgar. Take a look at the chart below. Infinitive form and simple past tense. Goes. Write, wrote. Go, went. Do, did. Read. The only thing that it would be changed will be the pronunciation. In present tense, I will say read the question, read the book, but in past we say read. Okay, according to this table, look at that the irregular verbs, they are going to change their form. Sometimes like cost, they are going to be the same, like cat. The three forms are the same. Another example of irregular verbs: sleep, slept. List of irregular verbs: begin, began, blow, blew, drink, drunk, dig, dug, fall, fail, grow, grew, ride, rode, rise, rose, run, shine, shone, sit, sat, threw, win, won, become, became, come, came, draw, forget, forgot, gave, get got, no new, ran, sink, sank, swim, swam, wake, woke, and write, wrote, okay? Entonces, chicos, este listado de verbos, a través de la práctica, los vamos memorizando. No es fácil, pero es cuestión de autodidactizarse un poco más estudiantes. Affirmative sentence: I cooked yesterday. He bought a new car last year. Interrogative and negative sentence: look at the formation of the negative and interrogative form in simple past. Did you eat my food? Oh no, I didn't eat your food. We have in the picture. As you can see, we are going to use did for questions and didn't for negative. Did will be placed at the beginning of the sentence. Did va a estar ubicado al comienzo de la oración. Nosotros en español pues hacemos las preguntas directamente. ¿Te comiste mi comida? ¿Te comiste mi comida? Entonces no utilizamos auxiliares. Pero en inglés sí vamos a necesitar auxiliares. Which is that auxiliary? Auxiliary did. En la traducción al español no significa nada, pero en inglés es una obligación utilizar did para las interrogativas en tiempo pasado. Did you eat my food? Oh, no, I didn't eat your food. So as you can see there, in order to make the negative form didn't, we are going to use auxiliary did plus not. And didn't is a contraction. Let's see another example. Questions and short answers. Did you do anything interesting at the weekend? Yes, I did. No, I didn't. This is the way how you are going to answer. Una pregunta cerrada de sí o de no. Yes, I did. No, I didn't. Yes, she did. No, she didn't. Yes, he did. No, he didn't. The simple past tense, regular. Here we have another San Marie. The simple past tense, regular. Play, study, shop. So we, as you can see there, it is added the letters ED. Sentence, I played soccer yesterday. In negative form, I didn't study yesterday. The contraction, I didn't study yesterday. Did you study for the English exam? Yes, I did. No, I didn't. Entonces, ahorita nosotros vamos a tener ejemplos de preguntas en pasado. Yo les voy a hacer a ustedes preguntas y ciertos ejemplos también los van a tener que cambiar al pasado siguiendo las reglas. Y notando si es un verbo regular o irregular, ¿ok? Ya mismo vamos a la práctica. Sigamos viendo acá otros ejemplos. This is the practice part. So, in the exercise number one, we are going to match with the correct verbal form, okay? With the correct past form. So you have 1 minute to read the column A and the column B in order to match with the correct simple past form, okay? 1 minute to see the information. We have the column A. Go, see, eat, buy, tell, say, make, hear, feel, and think. And in the column B, we are going to see feel, felt, went, thought, saw, ate, hear, bought, told, made, and said. Which is the correct past tense form of the column letter A? I will start asking the answers. So pay attention. Okay. Oh, perdón. Sorry. Okay. Carlos Guayamabe.
Thank you. Present.
The simple past of go. The simple past of go.
Sería went.
Went. Thank you.
Went.
Ajá. Cindy Jiménez.
Present.
The simple past of the verb C.
Present.
Yes, miss. The simple past of the
verb C. Jack.
Sorry? So, okay, thank you. So, the simple past of the verb eat, Karelis Tomala.
Karelis. At Aristóteles eat. María.
At.
Eight. Thank you. Shirley Chiriguaya.
The boy. ¿Cómo? La siguiente. ¿Cuál?
By, yes. The simple past of the verb by.
Voy, voy. La voy. Ay, no sé pronunciar esa ahí. La veo U, G.
Pronúncialo.
Pronúncialo.
Bow.
Bow.
Bow. Bow. Bow. Ok. Karen Morales.
Present.
The simple past of the verb tell.
Sí.
¿Tell?
Sí, sí, la primerita.
No, es told.
Told. Ah, told. No la vi. Okay. No lo vi.
Wilmer Alvarado.
Dígame, amiga.
The simple passing. Say.
Say. Say. Say.
Said. Said.
Said.
Pronuncia said. Ok. Jocelyn Hernández. The verb make.
Made.
Made. Thank you. María Fernanda. María Fernanda.
Hello.
Here.
Here.
Here. Thank you. Darío Tomalá.
Sir.
Feel.
Felt.
Felt. Okay. Jordan. Jordan Gilses.
Sí.
Sí.
Es the toe.
Dog. Okay. Very good.
Así la vivo yo en el colegio.
Now, write the correct past form. Correct past form. Entonces, tómele por favor una imagen. Tómele una imagen a esto y me lo envía en.
Apaguen el micro.
Que no se escucha.
Take a
repita, Mister, que se escucha.
Tómele una foto de esta página. Tómele una foto de esta página y la realiza como actividad en clase. Ya sabes que esas, las actividades en clase son enviadas con la evidencia al grupo de WhatsApp. Sáquele una imagen rápido a esta, a este slide del PowerPoint y continuamos.
Mister, yo tengo algo.
Dígame.
La anterior sí, la anterior hay que hacerla también.
No, no, eso era de forma oral.
Ok.
Ya.
Mister, disculpe, yo no tengo su número de WhatsApp, aún no estoy en el grupo.
Ya se lo dejo ahorita en el chat.
Ya, ya listo, gracias.
Okay, so we continue. Here we have the usage of there was and there were. Así como hemos tenido there is, there are, ahora tenemos there was and there were. Si there is en presente, considerar en presente significa hay. ¿Qué tenemos con there was in the, and there were en pasado?
Hubo.
Hubo. Ajá. Hubo o había. Perfecto. Let's see the video. Wait 1 minute while I am sharing the. Vayan resolviendo, chicos, el ejercicio mientras les pongo el video. Okay, students. Let's see the video. Can you see information?
Yes.
Was when there was only one, for example, there was one X on A. There was one kindergarten X. We use there were when there were more than A. For example, there were two cars on the road last year. There were 10 people in the classroom last year. When we want to say something, water, gas, sand, honey, salt, sugar, fire, music, art, oil, furniture, milk, everything. There was. There was water on the. There was money in my wallet. There was something on the bed. Now let's see how we make negatives. As there was or there were, and they were, we just make the verb negative. Look at the examples. There was. Don't remember, go back to the lesson and review it. You need to know this better.
Ok, chicos. Let me turn on my camera. There was a where in simple words in order to use había o hubo. If you had in the other examples, if you had in the other examples, there is some milk in the fridge. Now we're going to say there was some milk in the fridge. Había. Entonces, cuando a veces uno dice, pero allí hay, había, cuando ya se ha comido algo, ya se lo ha tomado, ¿sí? Entonces, no hay mucho que enfatizar en aquello, debido a que es la traducción del pasado. Cuando usted quiere decir había o hubo, entonces ya sabe cómo realizarlo. Chicos, ustedes van a tener un pequeño cuestionario, nos vamos a desconectar en este momento para volver a hacer otra sesión hasta las 2:15, en la cual ustedes van a tener que resolver el mismo. Les pido que rápidamente abran su email donde les va a llegar el link para la evaluación, ¿sí? Entonces, ahorita voy a cerrar esta sesión, nos volvemos a conectar para que no se nos corte a mitad del proceso de esta evaluación. Y les voy a pedir que todos prendan su cámara mientras la estamos realizando. ¿Ok? Nos conectamos nuevamente.